Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining how BGP prefers the lowest neighbor address. Now, this is just a very short reminder. If you do like these videos and you're interested in the topics I provide, please subscribe to the channel to get updates to new videos. And let me know in the comments below about topics that you would like me to address in the future. If you do like this video, please do click that thumbs up button. Now, the neighbor address in BGP is actually the very last attribute that's examined in the BGP best path algorithm. Now, someone might think the previous attribute that's checked is the router ID. The router ID, however, is unique. Why isn't that the ultimate tiebreaker? And what's the difference between the router ID and the neighbor address? Well, we'll be explaining all of this in this video. And the topology that we'll be using to explain it is this one here. Now, here we have two eBGP peers, and we can see that they are eBGP peers because they each exist within a different autonomous system. These two routers actually have two physical links between them, and they're also configured with a loopback interface each. Now, the first thing that we'll do is let's see what router ID is being used by each router. Now, how do we determine the router ID? Well, remember, first, if the router ID is manually configured, then that configured value is used. If it's not manually configured, then the highest IP address on an active loopback interface is used. And finally, if there are no loopback interfaces, it's the highest IP address on an active physical interface that's used. Now, in our case, we haven't manually configured the router ID in either router. And since we have active loopback interfaces on both, those IP addresses are used as the BGP router IDs. Now, this topology results in two eBGP peerings between the same two routers. So R1 can learn about the route to the 2.2.2.2 network via two different peerings. Now, at this point, you can probably see why the router ID is not the ultimate tiebreaker, because R2 will advertise that network to R1 with all attributes equal, including the router ID. So in this case, we need one more attribute to check to break the tie. That attribute is the neighbor IP address. Now, from the point of view of R1, after going through all of the BGP best path algorithm attributes, the very last thing that we will examine is the IP address of the neighbor on each link. So R1 will compare the 12.12.0.2 IP address of this interface to the 12.12.1.2 IP address of this interface. And since the lowest neighbor address is 12.12.0.2, then this path is chosen as the best path. Now, it's important to note that in any correctly and decently configured topology, it is best that some other attribute be used to determine the best path and not the lowest neighbor address. You should never need to reach this last resort tiebreaker. Even if everything else is left to its defaults, it is highly unlikely that you will get to this point. However, theoretically speaking, and sticking strictly to the designed algorithm, an ultimate tiebreaker was necessary to be part of the design, and that's why we have it here. Now, at this point, we finally reach the very end of the BGP best path algorithm. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.